resources to give children with autism in the local area a chance to have some social interaction every week. It's to get some experience with exercise and meeting new people and just learning from that and hopefully giving them some healthy habits to carry forth in their day-to-day lives.
I think especially during COVID, it's been particularly challenging for a lot of people. And so I think what we wanted to do this semester, still being online, was to continue to kind of have community and connection with the Little Beavers group that we had, you know, in a regular season. And so to be able to kind of do some virtual events and be able to see people in a virtual world was kind of the purpose of this season. And to be able to still do that was really rewarding.
Yeah, and building off of that, even though like this virtual season was a bit smaller than it usually is when we're in person, I think it was like a real joy just to be able to light up a few kids' faces when they were able to like talk about what they've been doing and what they're interested in, and just get to see the coaches they're familiar with and have a few laughs.
Yeah, I think also during the regular season, not during COVID, it's a real pleasure to be on the executive board and watch the growth that occurs across the board for all the athletes and the coaches as well. I think as a coach, you know, you work specifically with your athletes, so you see how they develop. But being on the exec board, you see sort of everybody in the whole picture and what it brings, how much joy it brings to the athletes and their families and the coaches. So it's a really unique opportunity.
Yeah, so basically we had three practices. They're only a half hour long on three different Sundays. And we had a lot more coaches sign up to help out than we had athletes sign up, which is understandable because the virtual setting is a little bit rough for people. But at least for me, the athlete that I've worked with in the past, who I wasn't paired with this semester because of being on exec, but anyways, it was nice to see the athlete that I usually work with, and the few times I stopped by his room, he was really excited to like see me, and also just seemed to be having a really good time talking to the coaches that he was paired with. And it seemed that he just really enjoyed like getting to talk and share things about his life, which was really nice to see him smiling and stuff.
First practice, we did some coloring sheets kind of centered around fitness. Unfortunately, we couldn't do any physical activity over Zoom, but to be able to kind of keep fitness in the conversation with these athletes was super important, so we try to do that. The second practice, we did like a show and tell where the athletes could bring in some objects that they really liked and kind of share them with their coaches, and the coaches could do the same. And then the third one, we had the athletes and coaches write cards to each other. And then they were able to email them afterwards. So we couldn't do any physical activity, but I think still those kind of educational, keeping fitness at the center of things, activities really, really were well received by the coaches and athletes.
One quick thing to add, which obviously I think being in person that we all agree is so much more fulfilling, so much more fun, just better in every way. But one thing that being online kind of let us do was like, the athlete could kind of stay around for as long as they were really willing to like kind of pay attention and to actually be present. So if their kind of time was up before that half hour, they could go back with their parents, kind of log off Zoom if they're kind of tired of the screen and everything. But we also had some athletes stay longer than that half hour that we planned out just because they were having a great time with their coach and really wanted to continue. So I guess like kind of a positive that came from being virtual is just like the athletes and their coaches could kind of stay on for as little or as long as was really best for them for that day, which was kind of unique. Usually, you know, our practices are an hour long and we can adjust time in there accordingly when we're in person, but everybody's there for an hour. At least when we're virtual, it really got to be tailored to kind of what our athletes were ready for that day.
Yeah, I think diversity inclusion, especially in Little Beavers organization, means just kind of having a greater understanding for people of all backgrounds, all abilities, all interests, and just kind of really learning to understand each other and appreciate each other's strengths and learn from each other's and grow from our weaknesses. And I think we just all, like, I know as a coach, I've learned so much from the athletes, and I hope the athletes have learned a little bit from us too along the way. So it's been awesome just getting to meet new people, and for them especially, where with autism spectrum disorder, sometimes social settings can be a little bit more difficult, and just like learning to navigate that in a super safe space, super inclusive, is just a great, it's a great time, both virtual and in person, to just have that community available for everyone.
Yeah, and just adding on to that, diversity and inclusion are very important to me personally, so it means a lot that that this program exists to help expand the scope of inclusion and in athletics to those who are neurodivergent too, and so that everybody can enjoy exercising, and that it's just great for everybody.
To get involved, so unfortunately we're done for this season, but very, very hopeful that it will be in person next season, and with that, hoping to recruit more athletes to come join us. And so if you are a student athlete, we will have an application process to sign up to be a coach, so be on the lookout for that, from someone on your probably varsity team will send it out. And then the best part about being with this group, I think, is just coming together every Sunday and kind of having something that's, you know, not school focused, not academic focused, not necessarily super related to your sport, but just something else to be a part of the community and to be part of something bigger. I mean, the smiles on these kids' faces are just priceless. And so to be able to contribute to that and really just learn so much from them is so rewarding, and I highly encourage anybody to do it.
I can also add a little bit, agree with everything Haley just said. The smiles are probably the best part of my Sunday every week when we get to do that in person. It's so awesome. But I think also just by nature of kind of meeting once a week, every week, like for the semester or for most of the semester at least, your athlete that you are paired up with as a coach is going to grow in some way. It's like inevitable they're going to grow, and to be along that journey with them and to watch that progress is just a super, super cool experience. And then at the very end, like, we do a kind of like awards kind of thing with our athletes, and you get to present them with like a little certificate and everything, and helping to show them and like acknowledge their progress that they've made over the semester is super gratifying, and to see their smile like at the end of the whole process too is super awesome. So like getting to just be along on that journey of like their progress, no matter if it's in kind of like making friends or if it's they wanted to be able to do 2 laps by the end and like now they can and they're exceeding it, they're at 3 laps or whatever their goal is, they're going to improve in some way, and it's a super rewarding experience to be there for that.